morning, we are joined by one third of the biggest girl band in the world.
Woo! Woo!
It's Jade Thirlwall!
Yes! Yay!
Tis I.
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, great, actually. It feels very strange being in here without the girls.
I was going to say, what's it like without them?
It's so bizarre. I've also realised that, like, I don't know how to say my name without saying from Little Me.
Oh, no, we know who you
Thirlwall.
Are.
Yeah, it's a bit of a tongue twister.
Do you feel more pressure because you've got to speak for everyone?
Yeah, and usually, you know, we bounce off each other and we look at each other to do different questions, things like that, and now it's all on me.
But I've seen in the past that the girls say you're kind of the one they lean on for the difficult, tricky questions.
Yeah, very true, to be fair. But it's just that energy, innit? It's having the girls around
Luckily,
you.
Luckily, we've prepared an interview full of very difficult questions.
Yeah, very difficult.
Great, thank you so much.
Easy.
Thrilled to be here.
We love Love Sweet Love, Yay. And I love that you're now using all that magic on yourself.
Of course.
It is an amazing song. How do you have time to do all of this stuff? And particularly the other girls have been quite busy.
I know.
Where did you find the time?
You tell me, hun. Do you know what I mean? Just very busy, yeah. I mean, we did a lot. I think the last week of work, we did like 3 video shoots in 1 week.
What? Jeez.
What? Yeah, and because obviously we were running out of time before the girls had to go off. So we just kept banking stuff to then, you know, reel out. But you know, it was still, it's always fun with the girls and we always make it work and we have a good laugh. But bless them, they were really feeling it by the end because, you know, we had swollen ankles and big bellies and the girls were tired and so they smashed it, to be fair. But there's plenty more to come as well.
Amazing.
It's funny because I saw actually some behind the scenes stuff and you were all sitting down with like electric fans, like shoes off.
Yeah.
And then you mentioned before that you were kind of like riding the wave a little bit. So when the girls got tired, you were like, yeah, no, my back too.
There's the thing is, it's like phantom pregnancy. Or like every time they were like saying something, I was like, yeah, me too. But I genuinely was feeling it as well.
I'm sure that wasn't annoying at all for them.
And do you know what as well? I genuinely kept bloating loads. So I don't know if my belly was. Like,
what?
I mean, I blow it anyways, hun. The minute I have a loaf of bread, a loaf. But I do eat a lot of bread.
Sis, have you checked that you're not pregnant?
No, I'm probably just very intolerant, but I'm never going to give it up. So.
You're not going to do the test even.
No, I know what it is. It's just me.
The carbs.
Eating all the carbs.
Now, Love Sweet Love was written by yourself, Leanne, Emanike. What was the inspiration?
Well, I think Sakima, who we'd never worked with before, actually, he's a producer and songwriter, he came in with a bunch of beats and then brought up that sample of Love Sweet Love. And so we were like, oh, this is amazing. We got, you know, vibe and ideas and melodies. And we're like, actually, this should be a self-love thing because that's, you know, what Little Mix love to do. And you could, interpret it however you want, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
You've worked loads, Jade, with Emanike. What is it about Emanike that makes you keep going back for more and more? Because everyone who works with him speaks so highly of him.
He just understands the assignment. He really does.
Such a teacher's report.
He does. He just gets it. He knows us so well. We've worked with him for years. So especially when we're on a certain time frame, we know we could just go in with him and we'll bash it out quickly and we'll get a good song from it. Because he knows our voices so well. He does a lot of our vocal production now too and production. So it's always, in and out very quickly and get the job done vibes for Emanike whilst it being, you know, really fun too.
That's interesting because a lot of people say like with music, there's no formula. You never know if you're going to get a hit song, but it seems like, you know, the minute you walk in with Emanike, you're like, we got it.
It's very rarely that we've done sessions with him that haven't really gone anywhere. Which, you know, it happens naturally anyways. Yeah. You can never tell when you go in the room, but I think especially for the girls, like obviously being pregnant and stuff, we had to allocate the time wisely and we love working with new people, but for this record especially, we had to, you know, stick to the people that we know and love already and bring in a few new people. So Love Sweet Love, we brought in Sakima and Lauren Aquilina, who was amazing. So it was nice having a few new faces as well as, you know, the good old days.
The OGs.
You're going on tour again soon. We can't wait to see you. What are you most excited about performing? Because you have loads of new stuff now.
I'm just gagging for it. Honestly. I am.
Okay. We won't take that out of context.
Yeah, don't. Yeah, make sure that's in this sentence. Yeah, no, I just can't wait to perform all of them. Confetti's never had its moment yet to shine. So, you know, we've obviously, so many of the artists have had to do this where we postponed the tour twice. And now it's like, you know, come next year and we just can't wait to get on stage and sing all those songs. You know, Confetti Live will be amazing.
Will there be Confetti?
Sweet Melody. You know it. Oh, I mean, it's very on the nose, but it's got to be done. So, just to do all them songs from that era would be amazing, because we've not really had the chance to do it.
Yeah, the mermaid era as well.
Oh,
the outfits.
Yeah, you know we love a costume moment. Mm. We love doing the most, so you'll get it all.
Oh, I can't wait. Staying on the theme of love, sweet love, what's the last thing you did to give yourself love, sweet love?
Oh, well... Well, I've had 2 coffees today.
There you go.
That is self-love.
That is. I mean, not sure if that's loving myself or just hitting me up with too much caffeine. But I actually do think I do a lot to love myself. One of them recently being not going on my phone too much. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you can get quite addicted, can't you? Seeing comments, things like that. So I try not to do that. And that's a good form of love, sweet love for yourself. And, you know, the obvious other reasons behind closed doors. Always loving myself.
Yeah, I mean, let's all love ourselves. Now we have to ask. The Little Mix babies are here. Yeah. Have you met them yet?
No!
What?
No! Well, you know what? I see it because I said this before in an interview and I saw an article being like, Jade admits she's never seen. I'm like, guys.
So dramatic.
They've just had babies. They're thinking about me in the face. Be like, oh, let's have a look then. You know, I've let them have a bit of time off and, you know, they don't want to... be around work too. I'm not saying that I'm just a work person, but you know, I'm very aware of giving them a bit of space. It's only been a few weeks.
I know, it's too early, isn't it?
Yeah, they need to spend glorious time with their families and their new bubbas. So, but I am actually seeing Leanne this week and hopefully Perry after that. So, I've seen plenty of picture and obviously I've been in touch with them every day.
Also though, Jay, between you and me, babies are really boring for like the first 6 months. They don't really do anything.
Yeah, I'm just skipping to the good bit. I'm just waiting around. Yeah. I'm like, let me know once they've got a personality, then I'll turn up.
Good vibes only.
Yeah.
We love the Anne-Marie collaboration as well.
Oh,
it's so good. If you were going to form a super group, and I feel like you could go that way, who would you add into Little Mix?
Well, defo Anne-Marie. She's got to be in it, surely. Mm. Namani, I'm obsessed with.
Namani, yes.
The choreography, hun. I can't even.
It's a lot.
Yeah. Tinashe, I love.
Oh.
And maybe Chloe and Halle.
You just smashed that line.
You have. I was thinking more like Mucha Buena.
I love Mucha Buena.
Mucha Buena, Posh Spice, just for the point.
Guys, what about Fleur East? She's an honorary lady.
Fleur East as well.
Our performance, James, I'm sorry, that's in my like top 3 performances when we did Sax and Black Magic. Oh, it was such a moment.
I loved that. I loved that moment. I got a taste of the Little Mix life.
You did.
A taste, and it tasted good, guys.
All right, that's a bit creepy now.
No, it was delicious. So the girls, all of you, Little Mix, made history last year at the Brits, the first girl group to win Best British Group.
I know.
Did you actually believe that that moment was ever going to happen?
No. No, I wanted to believe it would happen. And I think when we went to the Brits this time, we thought if this doesn't happen, we might have to do a little clapback. Do you know what I mean? Because I just think, even if it's not even necessarily about us winning, it's about women winning.
Yeah.
It had been 43 years.
I mean, it's just ridiculous.
Like the Spice Girls never won that. All Saints, Bananarama, like all these phenomenal girl bands. Mm. And so, you know, when we did win it, we were obviously unbelievably grateful and it was so emotional. But it felt like we were winning it for everyone, for all those girl bands previously who had probably deserved that award. And when we looked into it, a lot of the times when girl bands would be up for that nomination, they'd always have like outsold their like male counterparts. So I think, it was very telling and it was important to use that time and that moment to say that. But obviously winning Best Group was like... phenomenal. Yeah. And to win it 10 years in, and as a three as well. It was so nice to know that we were, yeah.
But it's such a good point, because we shouldn't be celebrating the first. We should be looking at it and going, why has it taken this many years for that to happen? That's the question that should be asked.
Yeah, you know, and no shade to anyone else that was nominated for that award. And yeah, it just felt like, come on, guys.
Come on.
I think the fans might have gone in uproar at that point.
Actually, things.
Do you know what I mean? So, I'm very, very grateful that we did win it, and it was nice to win it for all the ladies, and hopefully that paves the way for more girl groups to come.
Yes, Jade. Listen, you guys recently celebrated 10 years. An amazing milestone, amazing anniversary. It's actually my 10th wedding anniversary this week.
Aww.
And I've not thought of a decent gift yet. Can you give me any tips, having celebrated 10 years yourself?
Wow, any tips? Oh, I don't know. I think it speaks for itself if you've lasted that long, doesn't it? You're doing something right.
I'm not sure if my wife will be impressed with that.
No, I think you can obviously get. I think it's good to get something like some sort of keepsake, isn't it? What is it? What is it? 10 year anniversary. What's the thing?
What is that one?
Tin.
You might want to stop having affairs as well, Matt. That might help.
Maybe tin. Maybe you should get. I think it is the little things. One of the reasons we've lasted so long for 10 years is we do just. Have a laugh every day. Keeps you young, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Here comes the cry question. You are an inspiration at just like being yourself. So what advice do you have for anyone listening that is struggling with self-identity right now and is figuring out who they are?
I think it's okay to accept those moments when you're not feeling great about yourself. I think for a long time, whenever I felt a bit down or like I wasn't sure of who I was, I'd like almost like punish myself and give myself a hard time, because especially in the public eye for us, it's like we have this image of being, you know, confident and, you know, girl power, that stuff. But it doesn't mean there's times when we're not feeling vulnerable or doubting ourselves. But I think the minute you accept that and, you know, get help, if that's support from your family or therapy or whatever it is, whatever you need to do to, you know, be your best self is important, and it's good to be a little bit selfish sometimes, I think. And I think especially with social media at the minute, it's important to only like follow pages that are encouraging of who you are and don't make you compare yourself to them all the time or feel like you're not enough. You know, I think now and again I'll filter through and have a look and think, oh, actually, is this Instagram page or is this account benefiting me in any way? And if it isn't, then you have to go.
Oh, you get blocked.
Yeah, you have to. You've got to put, you know, because in this era, we're all on our phones all the time, aren't we? And we're all checking up on things. And yeah, I think it's important. And to always say good language to yourself. I have like, it sounds a bit like hippie, but I have affirmations on my bedroom wall, just like with positive things like you are amazing, you can do that. Do you know what I mean?
I love that.
And I know even if you're not looking at them properly every day, just waking up and seeing that in front of you gives you that little like positive.
Like a boost, isn't it?
Yeah. And something that I speak to my boyfriend quite a lot about actually is, like, you know, if you have a bad morning, that doesn't mean you're going to have a bad day. It's reminding yourself that, like, you know, there's ways of switching it up in the day if you're having a bad one.
So. Minute by minute or hour by hour. Dust
there
it
you
off
go.
And start
That's
again.
What it is. Yes. Yeah.
Now we need to get into Drag Race UK season 3.
Yes, please.
It's coming up.
I can't wait.
Oh, you were on the guest panel as a judge. You absolutely slayed that, by the way.
I loved
that
it.
That was so good, because that can be quite daunting as well, sitting on that panel.
Oh my gosh, it's quite intense. It all happens so quickly on the day as well, and because you want to do the most when you turn up. I think last time, what was I wearing? I was like corset in a dress, and I did the absolute most, and like just the most uncomfortable I've ever been, but for the cause. Because I think if these drag queens can come on in a cinch waist and a lace front wig, I cannot complain about wearing a dress. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, you don't want to do a Meghan Trainor turning up in a onesie?
No, I couldn't possibly. I'm sorry. I love Meghan Trainor, but I'm like, when I turn up a drag race, I've got to give them queens a run for their money. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You've got to show them why you've earned that spot on the chair.
Right?
So that's what happens. And I know Lee is being confirmed that she's on this season as a guest judge. So she was messaging me about it, some tips and stuff. And I know that she looks major for her guest slot, but it was so amazing doing it.
What would you do though if you were asked to come on as
a contestant?
In an ulterior universe? If to be a drag queen, what would your name be? Like, what would your character be?
Well, I have been named Shanida Nibbles before. because I do always take a snack with me on a night out.
Shanida Nibbles.
So there's that. That's yeah, so but I think I would be a very glam drag queen. Mm. Lots of colour, lots of glitter. You know, maybe a bit of fashion as well.
I want to see it.
A lip sync assassin. That's the goal.
Yes.
You want to be a lip sync assassin.
Mm. Yes. You know? I hope that hits the UK. You'd be amazing as a lip sync assassin.
Right? I mean, just even come on as a little demo. Like, just
me, yeah, just me turning up.
You're right.
Pretending
now
that
I have an example.
Like, wait,
aren't
you Jade from Little Mix? I'm like, no, I'm just.
Yeah. I'm Sheena Nibbles.
Oh,
sorry, I said that. I should not have said that word.
Thank God it's recorded. Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you so much, Jade from
thank
Little
you.
Mix. It's been an absolute pleasure.
That's been amazing.
Loved it. Loved being here in the room.